arts and crafts time, and what better way to spread a little holiday cheer than through decor? Digital reporter Kiera Sam is back in studio with us for this week's DIY, and I'm really excited about this because it's something you can definitely use in the coming weeks, right?
Right.
All right, let's talk about it.
So today we're gonna make a wreath. I've already started it. I got all of my supplies from the Dollar Tree, which is kind of my favorite spot now that I'm doing DIY. So what I really wanted to buy was the ring so that you could put your wreath around it and some garland. That's really all you need for a wreath.
Okay.
Some garland and a ring. The garland is kind of like tube.
Okay.
The little straw tubes that you put around, they're kind of bendy.
You can feel it. Yeah.
So it's really easy to put around the ring.
Okay. So it literally makes it easy to manipulate however you want.
Right.
So you just start twisting that around.
Right. And you don't want to make it too tight because then your wreath starts looking a little skimpy. And you want to keep it thick.
What is the ring? What is that? What is that made out of?
This is like some kind of wooden bamboo-ish situation. Okay. Actually, we have a wood blend wreath. Yeah. So it is a blend of different woods. And it's only a buck. Very lightweight, easy to work with. So you just wrap this around. So these pieces right here, a total of $2?
One piece.
One piece.
I cut them into pieces. So they're $1 for 15 feet of garland. And that one garland is
enough to create the entire thing.
Right.
All right, so once you have the garland on, let's talk about some of the accessories you're putting on top to really make this dazzle.
Right, so as you can see, I have some mesh tube. The mesh tube is a little hard to stick on to the garland, so I like to tape a piece first to the wreath. Just the end piece, and then everything else is just
twisting it right around the garland.
Right.
And it should stay because you have the stabilization of the wreath right here.
Right.
And then if you need to go in between the garland and the wreath, you have both of those different textures to work with. All right, pretty cool.
So you take the tube and you do it just like you did the garland.
Layer number two, wrapping it all around.
Right.
And what's really cool is Kiera's doing that. You've got some other festive little things that can all be found for just a dollar at the Dollar Tree. Let me tell you, the Dollar Tree is the holy grail when it comes to decor on a budget. So you got these cute little ornaments. There's some gold stars and what you've been hearing the entire time. The jingle bells. What is Christmas without the jingle bells, right?
Do you still believe?
Absolutely.
Me too.
The magic of Christmas is just amazing. And then you top it all off with a beautiful red bow. This is actually some pretty high quality stuff for just a buck.
For just a dollar.
Yeah.
I've already made my bow on this side. And it's just like tying your shoe.
All right, and then this is the finished product. So let's talk about uses. Normally on the front door, you're gonna have a much larger wreath, obviously.
Right.
But when you come indoors and you want to make the place festive, what are some places you suggest hanging this, Kiera?
I suggest your stairwell, your window. Honestly, some people get even a little more festive and put it on their car. Kind of like the little Rudolph reindeers, reindeer ears. So those are just a couple of cool places you can put them in your kitchen.
I have seen the reindeer ears on the cars in the holiday time.
Put them in front of your license plate.
You know what? I'm thinking I would want to put this on a guest door if I'm inviting people over for the holidays, just to welcome them in and let them know, hey, this is where you can call home for the next few days. So many different uses. Just cost you a couple bucks. It depends on how festive you want to get with your wreath, whatever your budget is you're working with.
Right.
And Kiera, if people want to follow you and keep up with some of what you're doing, how can they do so?
Yeah, go ahead and follow me on Twitter at SamKieraTV.
All right, good stuff. We're going to jingle all the way into this commercial break.